Hi, this is John with Hot Toy Sideshow Review, with a review on The Amazing Spider-Man from Medicom. Actually, up till 3 weeks ago, I was not a Hot Toys collector. I was really just into Batman, Superman, Spider-Man, and I wanted to get some accurate figures of them. I had seen the Medicom movie ones and didn't really appeal to me. I saw this one on the Sideshow website and it caught my eye and I loved it. I couldn't wait to get it. I had also planned on maybe getting a tumbler someday, but then said no because they're too expensive, and I was going to get a Dark Knight at some point. But I was going to be a collector. And this figure was my first purchase. And it was a little disappointing, to tell you the truth. The box is pretty cool. Looks like a comic book. Opens up. And he had a couple extra hands he had in there. But the first pose that I tried to put him in, his leg, I move the camera, decided to break at the joint. Now, I did declothe him and try to fix him, but this body is really brittle and weak. Now, for Spider-Man, you would assume he would probably be the most poseable figure that should be out there, considering what he can do. So, I was really disappointed when this happened. And I was pretty bummed out on the figures until I walked into a shop one day, and I was planning on getting a DC Direct Joker, and I ended up seeing a Hot Toys Joker that had just come off the UPS truck, and I matched the two together, and I had to have them, and it started an addiction. And as you can see, last 3 weeks on this website, I have become addicted, and I've decided to make this my hobby, and get rid of some other hobbies just for financial reasons. Luckily, I'm not married or with kids. But this figure was a disappointment, but it also was a learning experience that there are differences in companies. I did end up buying the Medicom Spider-Man from the movie Spider-Man 3. And the Peter Parker. The bodies are better, but I don't pose them, actually. I'm afraid to move them, so they're pretty much just standing there. You've seen the reviews, maybe, on the website. I won't be buying any more Medicom figures. That was one of the reasons I stayed with Sideshow on the Darth Vader. I just don't trust the quality. I'm really into the Hot Toys and for some Sideshow figures. But this was a real big disappointment. Anybody out there, don't waste your money on this figure, because in all likelihood, he will break somewhere. I could probably just pose him and break him now. The body is that brittle and unadjustable. So, thank you for listening to my little grief when it comes to Medicom and why you won't see a lot of figures on there, on the site. And thanks for your time. And I'll see you with the next Hot Toys review probably tomorrow. Bye.